Hello everybody, and welcome to another War Thunder event video this time, actually, not an upcoming content video, and that is the Victory Day Anniversary event. This one in particular is where you can obtain collectible vehicles for doing in-game tasks during the allotted time that's given. And this event will be running from the 8th of May at 11 GMT to the 11th of May at 11 GMT, which, so it's starting tomorrow, for me at least, and it will be starting, or ending in just a couple days. So you have about 3 days, 3-4 days or whatever to finish the event. And here is what you are battling for. So you have three new collectible vehicles, one of which I am super excited for, and I'll explain why. So for the three following nations, the USSR, because of course, Great Britain with a really new, a really funny new vehicle. And then of course the US, and those vehicles are as follows. The Russians will be a boat, the G5 TKA-106, which looks like a G5 boat with a mounted rocket launching system, because Russia needs to put rockets on everything. Speaking of rockets, the second one is the Swordfish Mark II for Great Britain, the aircraft, a biplane, Swordfish, but this one looks like it can fire rockets, which will make it a very interesting aircraft to add to the collection. And then, of course, the United States is getting the tank this time around, and it comes in the form of a vehicle I've asked for a very long time, the LVT-A4, which is an LVT with basically the M8 Scott's turret and gun. In my opinion, it's the traditional LVT tank that you see in Pacific theater stuff. So I'm happy to see it finally here in the game. And you can read, we can go ahead and give you a quick brief rundown of the descriptions here in just a little, in little bit. But let's take a look at what the tasks are. So to get the unique prizes, you need to complete any 3 out of the 5 tasks of rank 3 or higher. For naval battles, it's rank 2 or higher. So it's basically just like the marathon events where you do 3 of the 5 tasks to unlock the vehicle, but they've done it where if you want the tank, you have to play ground forces, if you want the plane, you have to play air forces, and if you want the boat, you have to play the ship mode. And here are the tasks. So for the LVT, the tank, you have to destroy 75 enemy vehicles in arcade or RB, or 38 in simulator battles. It doesn't say that RB is any less, so if you really have to get 75 kills in RB, I guess there's no multiplier. Win 20 times with an activity of 70% or higher, capture 25 points, helicopters count as well for capturing points, destroy 11 enemy vehicles in one battle, 6 for RB or 4 for SB, and help allies destroy enemies, so get 45 assists. Pretty steep requirements for all three of these if you plan on trying to get all three in a 3-day period, but the Swordfish is very similar, 75 enemy air kills, 38 in RB and SB, so I don't know why Ground Forces doesn't get a multiplier, but Air Forces does. Win 15 times with a battle activity of 60%, deal 15 tons of damage to enemy bases, destroy 11 vehicles in one battle, 4 for RB and 2 for SB, or get 15 assists. The G5, on the other hand, for naval forces, is deal 30,000 damage, win 15 times with an activity of 50% or higher, capture 10 points, seaplane and hydroplane captures count as well, destroy 3 enemies with torpedoes, aircraft launch torpedoes count also, be in first place at the end of the battle once. I've always hated the naval forces ones because of the first place one, and the fact that capturing points isn't as easy as 1-2-3, and getting victories isn't as easy as 1-2-3, because I find naval force battles last much longer than air or ground. But the ground and air ones are pretty straightforward and pretty easy to follow, so there's that. And of course, you can purchase the achievement with Golden Eagles before the 13th of May and get the appropriate vehicle immediately without completing tasks by going to Nickname, Achievements, and then 75 Years of Victory. Along with that, there's also the decal for Victory Day. You can get the Dove of Peace decal, which will be given to each player that wins at least 3 times in vehicles of rank 2 or higher with an activity of 50% or higher. So, there you go. A nice little thing. I'm happy to see that they didn't completely go full retard again with a crafting event for Victory Day tournament. They had a tournament, but obviously this is where they put the rewards, the specific rewards like this. And the vehicles are interesting enough. One of them's one I've asked for a while. The swordfish is nice to see because it's like, it's just funny to see another swordfish. This one actually having a set of rockets, which will be helpful for at least ARB, in my opinion. And then the G5, which is the least interesting for me, but at least it's interesting, you know, at least it's kind of unique. That being said, let's go ahead and take a look at the vehicle descriptions, and then I'll go ahead and cut the video. So the LVT-A4, it is an assault modification of a light U.S. amphibious vehicle designed for fire support during landing, or for landing forces during landing operations. The main feature of this version is the short 75mm howitzer in the tank turret. The tank was actively used in battles for islands in the Pacifics, where powerful high explosive fragmentation shells helped to crack open the firing points and fortifications of the Japanese coastal defenses. The LVT-A4 will be a good addition to the initial lineup of the U.S. ground forces. The short-barreled howitzer works great at close distances, and the ability to swim all allow attacking opponents from unexpected directions. Swordfish 2, or Swordfish Mark II, the second modification of the cult British ferry swordfish biplane, designed to be used for air assault attacks on naval targets. Version 2 received a metal sheathing below the wing to make possible for mounting RP-3 rocket launchers, which significantly expand the combat potential of this biplane. In particular, the swordfish can now be successfully used in low-rank mixed battles as well as for ground attack missions in aviation game modes. A living legend, a beautiful and very combat-effective aircraft, it is a must-have in your collection. Yeah, so one of the things to note is that this is a biplane that can carry rockets. Not like the Russian biplanes that can carry rockets because they're really tiny rockets. These are RP-3s, okay? So that's kind of really cool to see. And then lastly, the G5. So the G5 torpedo boats became the most common small vessel of this kind in the Soviet fleet during World War II. At the end of 1942, an experimental series of artillery boats was built in which torpedo equipment was replaced with rocket launchers. So I guess this doesn't have torpedo launchers, it just has rocket launchers. During the tests, the project was recognized as successful, and all six experimental boats were included in the 2nd Brigade of torpedo boats in the Black Sea Fleet. In War Thunder, the high-speed Sea Katyusha plays actively and boldly, sharp turns at high speed, non-stop machine gun bursts, and the grim howl of rockets. You need to give this a try. So yeah, there you go. Descriptions. If you don't have time to get all three, go ahead and pick your favorite one. You got one for air, ground, and sea here. And I'll see you guys on the battlefield. Or hopefully not, because that would be kind of awkward.